Good morning, everybody. See, my dear friends, in the sense now, in the last class, we were designing a 2-way slab, am I right now? 2-way slab, in which the corners are free to lift, am I right now? In the sense, here in the problem, he has stated that the corners are free to lift. Okay, so he has given you a slab of dimension 4 meters in this direction, 5 meters in this direction. Am I right now? And you have calculated the effective spans Lx and Ly as 4.2 and Ly as 5.2. Am I right, sir? No? That we have done. And also, you took the ratio of Ly by Lx, okay, no? And it was 1.24 approximately. Okay, no? So now, once you know this Ly by Lx ratio as 1.24, and since it is less than 2, okay, we took a decision that this acts as a 2-way slab. In a sense, it will try to now bend in this direction also, as well as in this direction. Okay, in both directions, it will try to now bend. Okay, so now, we will try to now start calculating the loads, etc., etc. Okay, now I will come down to this subplate of the slab. Okay, subplate of the slab, now 1 meter in this direction, 1 meter in this direction, okay, 1 meter by 1 meter on this area of 1 meter by 1 meter, okay. Thickness of the slab we have assumed it as now 140 mm, am I right now? 140 mm, so it is now 0.14, so this will give me the volume, am I right now? Volume into density of concrete will give me the weight. Oh, so now this is the self weight of the slab, okay. Similarly, if you just read the problem, okay, now he has stated that on the slab he has put granolithic finishing, okay, granolithic finishing of 20 mm thickness, okay. So now that weight of flooring, now I would like to now consider it, it's also a dead load, okay. So it is again 1 meter by 1 meter and the thickness of that granolithic flooring is 20 mm, so it is 0.2 meter, okay. Also, he has stated in the problem, you can take the unit weight of that granolithic finishing as 24 kN per meter cube. So it is 24,000 Newton per meter cube. Okay, so it is volume into density. It will give me the weight. Okay, so now its weight is now so much. Also, in the problem, he has given that the line load acting on the slab is 2000 Newton per meter square. So now, if I add all these things, it will give me the total load W, am I right? So now, I want to convert this W into ultimate load, am I right now? So ultimate load can be now calculated as now 1.5 times W, okay? So 1.5, W is now here, so it will give me ultimate load WU as, okay, 8783 Newton per meter square. Okay, so now this is our ultimate load. Okay, so but now what your IS code says is, now the question is, see, now first of all, I will try to solve this problem by using IS code. Okay, then I will solve it by using Gresham-Rankine's theory. Okay, so now first of all, I will take up now this IS code method now. Okay, see, what the IS code says is, bending moment in the shorter span Mx and bending moment in the longer span My, okay, Mx and My are given by some equations. The equation is Mx is equal to alpha x Wu Lx. What's that now? This is the equation given on page number 90. It is there. I will show you afterwards. Okay? Similarly, My, the bending moment in the longer span, okay? It is given by alpha y. Instead of alpha x, is alpha y. Wu will remain as it is now. And Lx, it is not Ly square. It is not Ly square. It is Lx square. Okay? So it is My is alpha y Wu Lx square. So both these equations are there on page number 90. Was that now? See now, Wu you know already. Wu is your ultimate load. Lx you know. Lx is 4.2. Was that now? And this alpha x and alpha y are called bending moment coefficients. Okay, alpha x and alpha y are called
bend moment coefficients, and they are given in table number 27 on page number 91. Okay, I will show you what they are exactly. Was that not? So now, by using this alpha x and alpha y, the bending moment coefficients, okay, I can easily calculate this mx and my. See now, in this equation, if I know alpha x, you know w, you know nx. If I know alpha x, I can easily calculate mx. Similarly, in this equation, okay, if I know alpha y, you know w, you know nx. So if you know this alpha y, you can easily calculate my. So now let us try to see now how we calculate this alpha x and alpha y by using this table number 27. Okay, so now I will stop it here. Tomorrow I will show you the next. Thank you.